How do you bring a city back from the brink of destruction? Antakya, one of the world's oldest cities, was nearly wiped out by a powerful earthquake. But 2 years later, something incredible is happening. In February 2023, a massive 7.8 magnitude earthquake hit Turkey and Syria, shaking the ground for just under 2 minutes, but the devastation lasted much longer. Buildings collapsed, roads cracked open, and entire cities were turned into rubble. Among the hardest hit areas was Antakya. But this isn't just any city. Once known as Antioch, it is a place with thousands of years of history, a cultural and trade hub that connected civilizations for centuries. The earthquake took 20,000 lives, demolished 3,100 buildings, and left families displaced. History, culture, and livelihoods nearly erased overnight. But today, Antakya is rising. Reconstruction efforts are underway to restore not just the buildings, but the city's heart and soul. From earthquake-resistant designs to preserving ancient landmarks, Antakya's comeback is a blueprint for resilience. Before we lay the foundation for Antakya's comeback, make sure to subscribe to DesignZip for more stories of construction and resilient design from around the world. After the earthquake, Antakya faced an impossible task. How do you rebuild a city that has been almost completely destroyed? Nearly 80% of the city was gone, and what remained was unstable. The streets were filled with debris, and thousands of families were living in container camps. The authorities could not just put buildings back up. They had to make sure the city never had to go through this again. In mid-2023, the Turkey Design Council took charge of the reconstruction efforts and launched an ambitious masterplan to bring Antakya back. Instead of going for a quick fix, they needed a long-term solution. The council knew this could not be done alone, so they assembled a team of global and local experts, including Foster & Partners, Bureau Happold, MIC Hub, DB Architects, and KeyM Urban Renewal Center. The team gathered to create a city that was stronger, safer, and more sustainable. The planning process was massive, as over 40 community meetings were held to gather input from residents, local businesses, engineers, and city officials. The goal was to design a city that respected Antakya's rich past while preparing it for the future. At that time, they set a $1 billion budget for the initial phase, and then the construction began. The first focus was the city centre. Before the earthquake, Antakya's old town was a dense, lively area with a mix of historical and modern structures. But after the disaster, most of it was reduced to rubble. The new master plan is bringing it back, but this time with major upgrades. 5,000 new housing units are being built to make sure that displaced families have a place to return to. Alongside them, 2,000 commercial spaces are being developed to bring back businesses that had been lost. There used to be a famous Ozon Bazaar in this city, which was once a central hub for trade and daily life. It is being reconstructed right now with traditional materials to make sure it retains its historical charm while meeting modern safety standards. But rebuilding does not mean they're just putting up new buildings. They have to make the city functional and connected as well. This is why a new public transportation network is being developed to improve the way people move around. Antakya has long struggled with congestion, and the earthquake has only made it worse. The solution right now is a design that prioritizes pedestrian-friendly streets, bike lanes, and better road systems. They are also introducing superblocks, which are large sections of urban development with shared public spaces to improve traffic flow and reduce unnecessary congestion. These changes will make it easier for residents to navigate the city, whether they want to navigate on foot, bike, or through public transit. Beyond the physical infrastructure, one of the best aspects of this master plan is the preservation of Antakya's historical and cultural landmarks. You see, this city was one of the oldest continuously inhabited places in the world. It carries the legacies of Romans, Byzantines, Ottomans, and countless others. The earthquake had left many of its historical sites in ruins, but rather than simply clearing the debris, efforts are being made to restore and protect these landmarks. For example, the Habibi Nekar Mosque, which is one of Anatolia's oldest Islamic sites, is undergoing careful reconstruction along with churches, synagogues, and other places of worship that had stood for centuries. The ancient Roman roads beneath the city are also being studied and preserved to make sure Antakya's history remains part of its future. At the same time, there's a major push to make the city greener and more sustainable. Before the earthquake, Antakya had limited public green spaces, with only 136 square meters of parks and gardens. That number is now increasing to 778,000 square meters. This is a dramatic expansion that is going to improve the city's air quality, reduce urban heat, and create more recreational areas for residents. Other than for aesthetic reasons, trees and vegetation are being planted to help in flood prevention and climate control. The Asi River, which ran through Antakya, had always been prone to flooding, especially after heavy rainfall. To counter this, the new master plan avoided construction along high-risk areas and instead introduced buffer zones, wetlands, and green corridors. These areas will help absorb excess water and prevent future disasters. Another great thing about this master plan is its sustainability. The new homes and commercial spaces are going to have smart features. For example, many of them are incorporating solar panels, energy-efficient insulation, and smart water management systems. These incredible features are going to reduce waste and lower utility costs for residents. The city is also pushing for more electric buses and dedicated bike lanes. This is going to cut down on car dependency and lower emissions. One of the major focuses of the master plan is infrastructure resilience. You see, while it's difficult to rebuild a city, it is even harder to make sure that if another earthquake hits, the destruction will not be as catastrophic. This means the team had to completely rethink how and where things were built. Structures now had to meet strict earthquake-resistant standards, with deeper foundations, reinforced materials, and flexible designs that could withstand seismic activity. This is why they changed the layout of the streets. Narrow, winding alleys that had made rescue efforts difficult are being replaced with wider roads and strategically placed public plazas that would double as emergency gathering spaces. These open areas are designed to serve as safe zones where people can seek shelter in the event of another disaster. Essential services are also being reinforced. For example, hospitals, schools, fire stations, and emergency response centres are being relocated to safer zones. By safe zones, we mean these areas are away from places that are prone to soil liquefaction or landslides. Beyond infrastructure and sustainability, the master plan is also focused on rebuilding Antakya's community spaces and public services. We all know that a city is more than just its buildings. It's about the people who live there and the spaces they share. To encourage a sense of normalcy and bring life back to the city, new cultural centres, concert halls, libraries and theatres are being constructed. Parks and public squares are being designed as places where people can gather, hold events, and rebuild their community bonds. However, with a project this massive, there were inevitable challenges and delays. So, what are the main challenges being faced in this reconstruction plan? Rebuilding Antakya was never going to be easy, but 2 years in, things are moving slower than expected, and not just because of the sheer scale of destruction. There are some serious roadblocks getting in the way. For example, there have been some property disputes. Antakya's old town was a maze of shared buildings, inherited homes, and multi-owner properties, some without proper documentation. Now, after the earthquake, who actually owns what? That's a legal mess nobody was prepared for, and it is causing major delays. Then there is the fight between speed and preservation. The government wants to rebuild fast, but locals and historians are worried that in the rush, Antakya's soul is getting lost. The city has thousands of years of history, and if developers are not careful, we could end up with a generic modern city instead of one that respects its past. And let's talk about money, because rebuilding an entire city is not cheap. The cost is estimated in the tens of billions, but so far, only a fraction of that is secured. If funding does not keep coming, construction could stall, leaving parts of the city unfinished for years. The Masterplan aims for completion by 2025, but with so many challenges, people are sceptical. Will Antakya be fully rebuilt by then? At this pace, it is looking that it might take a few more years. Antakya's story is one of resilience, innovation, and hope. From earthquake-resistant homes and revived historical landmarks to greener public spaces and smarter infrastructure, the city is rebuilding with both its past and future in mind. With 5,000 new homes, 20,000 commercial spaces, sustainable transport solutions, and expanded green zones, Antakya's master plan is shaping a safer, more sustainable city. Yet, challenges like property disputes, funding issues, and balancing speed with heritage preservation still stand in the way. But what do you think? Will Antakya become a model for rebuilding historical cities after disasters? Or do you think the road ahead is still too uncertain? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. I'd love to hear your perspective. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to DesignZip for more stories about architecture, design, and construction from around the world. There's a lot more coming your way. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.